In this MetaMask tutorial, I'm going to show you how to install, set up, and use your MetaMask browser extension. I will also show you some useful tips and tricks along the way so you can become a pro at using this crypto wallet. And as a bonus, towards the end of this video, I will show you how to earn some passive income using your crypto assets. So make sure to stick with me to the end. But for now, let's get started.
MetaMask is a free cryptocurrency wallet which can be accessed through your browser extension on Chrome, Firefox, Brave, and Edge browsers. It is also available on your smartphone app and will allow you to interact with decentralized applications or dApps on popular blockchains like Ethereum, Binance, and Matic Network, to name a few. Now let's get started by downloading MetaMask. I recommend you type this in word by word rather than typing it into Google and clicking on a link, as you may go to a phishing site and they can steal data off you. So once you come to the homepage of MetaMask, you can click on download now. And in this tutorial, I'm going to use the Brave browser. But as mentioned before, there are a few other different browsers you can use. So I'll click on Install MetaMask for Brave, and it'll take me to the official Chrome Web Store. Then you click on Add to Brave, click on Add Extension, and that's it. My MetaMask has now been successfully added. And now we can click on Get Started, and you'll be presented with two different options. You can either import your wallet if you've previously created one before, or you can create a brand new wallet, which we're going to do now. Now MetaMask will ask for permission to collect your data. You'll have to agree on this to be able to proceed. Some of you may not be happy about giving up your privacy, and I do agree with this, so I have a quick fix here that you can use, which I do for my own account. And you can go onto your extension section, and I'll pin this. And under this hamburger, you can go to here and select when you click the extension only. This means that MetaMask is automatically turned off and will only start collecting data when you're using the app only, which is when I click on this icon. So that's a way of minimizing your data sharing. And now we'll click on agree. And now you want to create your password. And remember, this password is only for logging in from this browser. It is not the same as your recovery phrase or your private keys for your actual crypto account. I will show you how to get to them later. Now put in your password, agree to their terms, and then click on create. Then click on next, and this is where you can get access to your 12-word recovery phrase for your account. So make sure to copy this and keep it somewhere safe that you can always come back to. Because if you ever lose this, you won't have access to your account. And once you've copied it, you can click on next. And now we have to enter in all these 12 recovery words in the correct order to be able to log in. Once you have done that, click on confirm. Click on done. And here is our brand new MetaMask account. Once you have made it to your dashboard, the very first thing I recommend you do before anything else is to go and locate your private keys and also copy that over to a safe location somewhere. So to do that, you click on this three dot here and go to account details and come down and click on export private key. It'll now ask you for the MetaMask password. So this is the same password that we created at the beginning. So type that in, click on confirm, and copy the private keys over to a safe place. Now the next thing is we can change our account name, and we can come back to the three dots, click on account details, and then click on the pencil icon here, and type in the account name that you want. This will make it a little bit more personal for you, and so you can keep track of which account is which if you have more than one account. And down here with this set of numbers and letters, if I click on it, it'll show my full wallet address. And you can copy it by right-clicking and copy, or you can scan the QR code here, which will reveal the same wallet address. And another way to copy the address is to go back to the dashboard and just click on this account name here. It'll copy your wallet address. And now that we have covered the basics on the MetaMask dashboard, let's move on to the settings. You can do that by clicking on the top right hand circle here and then coming down to the settings tab. So from the general section, you can see that you're able to change your currency, and it can be changed to any major currencies in the world. Another handy feature here is that you can change your currency to fiat or keep it in the main cryptocurrency. Some people like to think of their assets in terms of dollars, so if that's the case, you can click on fiat. And now you can also change the language to whichever one you want. MetaMask supports a lot of different languages here, so it may be useful for you, but I'll keep it at English. Next, we can go to advanced. If you want to sync MetaMask with your phone, you can easily do that by clicking on sync with mobile, enter in your password, click next, and you simply download your MetaMask mobile app and then scan this QR code. But if you want more information on how to use your MetaMask mobile app, then I have an in-depth tutorial on my channel that you can check out. Now the next button here is a reset account button. This will not affect your main account in any way. It will not log out of your account or delete your password or anything. All it will do is clear your transactions if they are clogging and not going through. So this button comes in very handy if the network's congested or for some reason your transaction's not going through. Now the next thing is advanced gas controls. This is also useful for you to control how fast or slow you want to make your transfer and how much of the fees you want to pay for those transactions. And I'll show you how to do this later on in the video. Now the next important feature which I recommend you use is this auto lock timer. This means that MetaMask will log you out of your account after a certain number of minutes. Set something about 5 or 10 minutes, I'll click on save. This means that after 5 minutes of not using MetaMask, it'll automatically log me out. So this is another safeguard to keep your account safe, so no one can access your MetaMask account when you don't want them to. Now the next thing is to go to our security and privacy section, and this is where you can get your 12-word recovery phrase if you forgot it or lost it somewhere. And that's about the basics covered for the main settings. The next thing I want to quickly show you is how to add a different blockchain which is not pre-installed on MetaMask. You can see here we have Ethereum, but the main ones that are probably missing here is Binance and Matic. So I'll quickly show you how to add those. We can go to networks and enter in these values manually, or you can go to chainlist.org and then type in the network that you want, in this case, Binance. Now I clicked on connect wallet and click on add to MetaMask. And here's a network name, URL, and chain ID pre-populated for you so you don't have to type it out. And then if we're happy, click on approve and click on switch network. And I'll do that for Matic as well. This makes it very easy, but you need to make sure to select the right blockchain. So you can see here, Matic has a mainnet and a testnet. We obviously want to use the mainnet. But this is something that you need to check in your research before adding your blockchain. So here I know this is the correct one for Matic, so I'll click on add to MetaMask and do the same process again. So now that we've quickly added the Binance Smart Chain and Matic, we can go back to our MetaMask account and hover down from this arrow sign, and you can see Binance Smart Chain and Matic Mainnet has been added successfully. Now the next tip I want to recommend you do before you make any transfer to other people is to go to your contacts and add wallets that you know that you'll regularly use. For example, it may be your Ledger wallet or your other secondary wallet or close family members or business partners. But it's always good practice to have a frequently used address saved on your MetaMask so you don't always have to double check your addresses and search for them. And I'll quickly show you how to add one here. So I'm just adding myself and click on save, and there I am. The next step is to add our tokens. So we can go back to our dashboard, and from the dashboard, you can click on add token. We can type in the token name that we want to add. But in this case, if we're on the Ethereum mainnet, then we need to be adding a token from the Ethereum chain. Otherwise, it will not work and won't show up. So let's say I want to add Uniswap. Then I would just type in Uniswap. And you can see here Uniswap comes up, but you do need to be careful here as different tokens can be given the exact same name. And if it is scanned and showed up here for you, like for this example, you can see AirSwap token also appears after you type in Uniswap. So what I like to do and what I recommend you do instead is to go to CoinGecko and type in Uniswap from here and then copy this contract address here. And you can verify this address 984 on CoinMarketCap to double check that it is correct. See that? 984. So once you're sure it's correct, then go to custom token, paste it into the token contract address, and now it automatically comes up as Uni, so you know for sure this time that it is the correct token that you're after. So you can click on next and then click on add token. So now we have the correct token added to our MetaMask. This is a very important step to take, and you need to make sure it's the right token so you don't get scammed. That's a very important tip for you here. So now with all that out of the way, we can now go and buy or exchange our tokens. So you can buy crypto straight from MetaMask by clicking on this buy button here. And if you continue to wire, they will allow you to directly purchase Ethereum with your credit or debit card. So you can see here, you just simply have to select the amount that you want, $100, and you will get 0.488 Ethereum. You can pay with your Apple Pay or your credit card. But you can see here, the exchange rate is not always going to be the best. For example, right now, it's around $2,050. But if you go to CoinMarketCap and CoinGecko, it's going to show you around $1,950 per Ethereum. So you're losing around 5% there. Plus, you're gonna have a high transaction fee of a minimum of $5 per transaction, or up to 3 or 4%, which is really high on top of the 5% that you already lose from the Ethereum exchange rate. Then you also have to pay the network fee for transferring your Ethereum to your account. So this is there for you and is really handy and quick if you wanna fund your account quickly, but I generally don't recommend this method. If you want to know the best way to do this, then I have this video here which shows you the best exchange to use to purchase your cryptocurrency. So now we can go back to our dashboard again. So now let's go and make a transfer and send some funds if we had any. So you click on send, put in the Ethereum address that you want to send your funds to. In this case, I'll just use my own address. Now you can select the amount that you want to send and then choose the amount of transactions fee you're gonna use. So obviously the more you pay, the faster it's gonna be. So you can choose the slow option, average, or the fast option. Or you can click on the advanced option here and customize your own gas limit and gas price. So the gas price, known as Gwei, is basically a subunit of Ethereum, which is like looking at Gwei being the cents to Ethereum, a dollar. That's the easiest way to explain it. So at different times of the day, the network will be congested to a certain amount. So the number of Gwei you'll need to use for your transfer will always be different. And a good resource for this is to go to ethgasstation.info. This will give you a rough idea of what you need at this time to make your transfer. So we can see here, if we want our transaction to go through right away, you're gonna need to input 24 Gwei. If you want it in under 2 minutes, it's about 16, and in less than 5 minutes, it's about 11. This can add up and be very expensive depending on how much you put in. But here's a quick tip for you. If you're only transferring to yourself or making a non-urgent transfer where you can wait a few hours, then there's a transaction calculator here which you can utilize. So you just click here on the calculator, and from this page, you can go to other and type in, for example, 5, and then click on submit. And this will show you an estimate of how many seconds roughly it will take for your transaction to go through with 5 Gwei. So here it says 62,000 seconds, which equates to roughly 17 hours, but it's going to save you so much in gas fees. And if it's worth it for you to wait and save on the fees, then that's what you should do. So you can see it's a lot cheaper and the savings are much bigger, especially in congested times. So this technique may be worth it for you.
And if you're finding tips like this helpful to you so far, then you can thank me by hitting that like button and subscribe to my channel if you want more of these videos.
So now you know how to buy crypto and then send that crypto to someone else, but MetaMask still has another unique feature which you can utilize, and that is their swap feature. You can click on swap here from the dashboard. So this MetaMask swap feature is a really cool and unique feature. They act as an aggregator of decentralized exchanges. So if you already have your funds on your MetaMask account, rather than having to send it to a centralized exchange like Binance or Coinbase and then purchasing the crypto that you want, you can simply do it right off your MetaMask account without having to connect to websites like Uniswap or SushiSwap, and you'll automatically get the best rates from all these sites. So I'll show you an example here. If I want to swap one Ethereum for my Uniswap token, you can see here MetaMask are going to find the best rate they can get for my Uni token. So now under the advanced option is the slippage tolerance, and it's preset at 3%, and you can change it to 2% or any other number you want. So what I normally do is the 2% that they had here, but if you're making a very large order, you may need to bump this up to 4 or even 5% to make it go through. But this basically means the amount that a price can change between when you execute the order and when the order goes through. So now once we're happy with this, you can click on review swap. And now you can see MetaMask is searching on exchanges like 1inch, Uniswap, and a few others to get you the best rate possible. And they've come up with 5 different quotes, as you can see, and we select the cheapest one. But do note that MetaMask does charge a 0.743% fee on top of the best rate they can find. So it may be worth it for you overall still, as you're getting the best rate. So I think overall this is a really good feature to have, and I use this feature for myself too.
Here's a quick question for you. What do you think of the swapping feature that MetaMask has? Will you be using it yourself? Let me know in the comments section below.
So now I want to quickly show you some tips on making live transactions. So first of all, I want to go back to settings and advanced, and then go and turn on this advanced gas controls. So we have full control of our gas fees. Now I know some of you may want a safer way of storing your crypto assets, like on the hardware wallet, which I also do myself. but you're also able to connect your hardware wallet to MetaMask. And if you want to do this, you just go to the top right hand corner, click on this circle button, and then go down and click on connect your hardware wallet. So with MetaMask, it's possible to connect either your Ledger wallet or your Trezor wallet. For this example, I'll show you the Ledger by clicking on that. So you have to plug in your Ledger wallet and open the Ethereum app. I've also got a full Ledger and Trezor tutorial on my channel that you can check out if you need some help on setting that all up. So now that I'm in, I click on continue and it's going to search for my Ledger wallet. And now it's found all my accounts and I can just select one, click on unlock, and there it is. I am now logged into my Ledger wallet through MetaMask. Very simple method. And this is the best way of using MetaMask in my opinion, and this is what I do. So as soon as I unplug my Ledger from the computer, bam, no one can access my crypto wallet at all, and my funds are safe. So that's what I also recommend you do if you can afford it. I never keep more than a couple of $1,000 on a MetaMask account without the Ledger connection. This isn't financial advice, obviously. It's up to you what you do with your funds, but that's just what I do. But if you don't have a Ledger, but still want to create a new MetaMask account, you can go to here also and click on create account instead. Or if you already have an existing MetaMask account and you want to recover it, you can just click on import account here, paste in your private key, which I showed you earlier how to get, and then click on import and your account will appear here again. If you already hold some crypto and are looking for more ways to diversify and earn more passive income, then you may as well take advantage of these bonus offers I have, which is worth $375. You simply just have to go to the links in the description below and sign up for these platforms and start staking your cryptos. You can see here, through my links, BlockFi will give you up to $250. Celsius Network is going to be a $50 bonus. Crypto.com is also not bad at $25. Same thing with Ledin at $25. And lastly, Voyager is going to be $25 as well. My favorites, which I use for the long term, are BlockFi, Celsius Network, and Crypto.com. But Ledin and Voyager is still worthwhile signing up and getting the bonus as well. Now, if you want more information and more ways of earning passive income through your crypto assets, then I strongly recommend you check out this next video here. But if you need more help on your MetaMask wallet, like setting it up with other wallets or dApps, or even connecting it to other blockchains, then I have this full MetaMask playlist here, which you can go and check out and pick the next video for you. And I'll see you over in the next tutorial.